Instead of throwing away glass bottles, especially empty beer bottles, you can easily turn them into useful, creative, or uniquely decorative items for your home. From recycling them into vases, decorative lights, or small storage containers to more complex, I will turn a glass bottle into a surprisingly improvised welding device. The glass bottle will serve as a key structural component this time, combined with suitable parts to create a device capable of basic welding, useful for small repairs and DIY projects at home. After thoroughly cleaning the bottle caps, I will drill a hole in the exact center of each cap. This step needs to be done carefully so the hole is perfectly centered, ensuring the two caps are balanced and easy to assemble later. Once completed, these drilled holes will serve as the main connection points, ready for installing an axle or attaching the next components. Next, I will pour sand into the bottle until it is completely full. The sand should be added slowly, gently shaking the bottle during the process to help it compact and minimize any empty spaces inside. Once the bottle is fully filled, its weight increases noticeably, making it much more solid and stable and ready for the next step of sealing the cap or securing it to other components. Next, I will use a nail as the welding tip. The head of the nail is slightly sharpened to create a smaller, more focused contact point, which helps achieve greater precision when working on small details. After this modification, the nail tip looks cleaner and sharper, ready to serve as the welding tip in this improvised setup. Then, I insert the sharpened nail through the hole in the bottle cap, making sure the pointed end faces outward and stays aligned with the center axis. When positioned correctly, the nail passes straight to the center of the cap, looking like a purpose-built component, neat, well-aligned, and secure. I will secure the nail by combining baking soda and super glue. First, I sprinkle a small amount of baking soda over the area, then apply the glue at the contact point between the nail and the bottle cap. This mixture hardens almost instantly, forming a very strong bond that keeps the welding tip firmly in place and prevents it from wobbling during use. Once fully cured, this section becomes rigid and stable, making the entire structure look neater and more reliable. When the bottle cap is screwed back onto the bottle, the sand packed inside begins to show its effect clearly. The sand surrounds the nail, helping keep it straight and minimizing vibration. Next, I'll prepare a length of electrical wire of suitable size and secure along the body of the glass bottle using hot glue. The glue is applied evenly and pressed firmly, so the wire adheres tightly to the bottle surface, preventing it from shifting during handling or operation. After that, I will neatly wrap the electrical wire around the neck of the bottle to secure it and prevent tangling. Wrapping it tightly along the neck keeps the wire flush against the bottle, avoids any excess sticking out, and also provides a firmer grip when holding it. Once finished, the overall setup looks cleaner and more organized. After finishing the first welding tip and checking its stability, I will move on to making the second welding tip. This one is prepared in a different orientation to better suit a wider range of use cases. Next, I will repurpose the core of an old battery to make the welding tip for the second head. Although these batteries have already been used, their internal structure still has value for reuse in DIY experiments. Here, I will choose a completely depleted battery and take advantage of its metal core as a contact tip. Its shape is suitable and it provides an alternative welding tip option compared to the first one. After that, I separate the battery to extract the metal core inside. At this step, the main goal is to obtain a core with suitable shape and size to be used as a welding tip, while the outer battery casing is no longer needed. I will use a bolt and nut to firmly attach this welding tip to the remaining bottle cap. The bolt is inserted through the drilled hole in the center of the cap. The battery core is positioned correctly, and then tightened with a nut to create a secure connection. This method keeps the welding tip stable and properly aligned, while also allowing it to be removed, adjusted, or replaced when needed, and makes the overall structure look cleaner and more solid. Next, I will use an electrical terminal block to connect the welding tip to the bolt in a neat and secure way. The terminal block acts as an intermediary, making the contact point between the welding tip and the bolt more stable, while also allowing for easy removal or adjustment when changes are needed. I attach the prepared battery core to the designated position, aligning it properly along the axis and ensuring the contact is straight. Once the battery core is installed, the entire assembly becomes more cohesive, with the welding tip firmly in place and clearly looking like a complete, integrated component. Next, I will connect one end of the electrical wire by attaching an alligator clip. The wire end is stripped just enough and then firmly secured to the clip to ensure good contact. This alligator clip makes a connection more flexible, allowing for easy attachment and removal during testing or configuration changes, while still keeping the entire setup neat and secure. The electrical wire at the end of the bottle will be connected directly to the welding tip to form a seamless connection. Once the wire is attached in the correct position, the welding tip and the bottle body become a unified assembly with a clean appearance and a clearly defined structure. I will first use the bottle cap fitted with the nail that was completed earlier. This welding tip has a simple, sturdy structure and is easy to control, making it well suited for initial testing and getting familiar with the setup before switching to the second tip. Once attached to the bottle body, the entire welding tip sits firmly in place, ready for the next steps during use. For the power source, I'll be using a standard motorcycle battery. It's a 12E lead acid battery, powerful enough to heat up the soldering tip and stable for small electronics work. This type of battery is easy to find, rechargeable, and delivers consistent current, which makes it perfect for our DIY soldering project. Now it's time to put our DIY soldering tool to the test. I'll begin by trying to solder onto this razor blade, which is thin and metallic, making it a good challenge to tool. After that, I will wrap tape tightly around the bottle cap to seal any gaps. This layer of tape helps keep the sand inside from leaking out when a bottle is tilted or turned upside down, while also adding extra strength and stability to the cap. Thanks to the nail tip being neatly sharpened and having a small cross-sectional area, heat is concentrated more effectively, allowing the welding tip to respond quickly and be easier to control. When soldering onto a razor blade, the effectiveness of the welding tip becomes very clear. Thanks to the tip heating quickly and maintaining focus heat, the solder adheres firmly to the thin metal surface of the blade without slipping or clumping. The joint forms quickly and creates a strong bond, securing small components or wires in contact with the blade. At the same time, because the heat is well controlled, the surface of the blade does not overheat, preserving its shape and ensuring safe handling during the process. After testing the nail-based welding tip, I will remove that cap and replace it with the cap fitted with the prepared battery core. Once the new cap is screwed on, the welding tip immediately takes on a different form, looking sturdier and more substantial. This change makes it easy to compare the two types of welding tips and shows that simply swapping the cap allows the entire tool to flexibly adapt to different usage needs. When using the welding tip made from the battery core, the welding experience feels noticeably different compared to the nail tip. The battery core has a larger cross-section, so it retains heat better, with a more even and stable temperature during operation. When applied to the point being worked on, the weld appears smoother and more consistent, making it especially suitable for components that require longer heating times. When the welding tip touches the wire joint, heat from the tip is transferred directly to the contact point, causing the solder to melt quickly and coat the wires evenly. At this stage, the joint gradually becomes seamless, strong, and has a shiny surface. Thanks to the tip heating up quickly and maintaining a stable temperature, the soldering process runs smoothly, securing the wires firmly without damaging the surrounding insulation. When soldering the joint, the solder adheres very well to the wire, almost fully coating the copper strands inside. Thanks to the welding tip maintaining a stable and focused heat, the solder flows evenly without clumping or spilling out. Once cooled, the joint becomes solid, durable, and conducts electricity effectively, ensuring a stable connection while also looking neat and professional. After completing the setup and testing both welding tips, the DIY soldering tool is fully functional and versatile. By simply switching caps, it can adapt to different types of tasks, whether precise, quick weld with a nail tip, or more heat-demanding joints with a battery core tip. The combination of a sturdy glass bottle base, secure internal components, and neatly routed wiring creates a compact, reliable, and safe-to-handle tool. This project not only demonstrates the potential of repurposing everyday materials, but also provides a hands-on solution for small repairs and DIY electronics work at home.